It's not April 7th. So, I will take you through a few things which sets up the day for you. Like I said, it's a day of learning. The best way to learn is to relax. And the best way to relax is to have fun. So we're not going to crack jokes, but we're going to have a discussion which will make you relax. Because the hard stuff, the mathematics, the formula is coming from the better people than me. This is a nice quote, I believe, very much applicable to a human being, especially the stage you are in. The mind is like a garden. You plant flowers, you get flowers, whatever flowers. You plant weeds, you get weeds. But the danger is this: if you plant nothing, you still get weeds. So if you do nothing, you are a fertile set of people with nice, you know, activity going on. So don't lose it. Okay, that's the message. Just definition of an innovation typically, this is completely from the commercial point of view, is an opportunity with a solution which combines something new and something useful. So if you can create a solution for an opportunity which is new and useful, it starts up forms an innovation. Now, why is it innovation is important? Because every company needs innovation. Either it is to create new features, new products, new services, new user experiences, and so on. We all know a lot of examples of this. This is where the company shows that they have something new and they can also charge. For example, a phone company can say we have this feature as new, and they say this costs 400 rupees or 2000 rupees more than the previous model. There could be also innovation in the bottom line. A car company, for example, could say we have a new airbag which, or an emergency braking system which they can charge the customer. Or they can say we have a new robotic way of painting which uses less paint or which ensures more quality of paint to last longer or whatever the process, and try to save money for the company which the customer may not see. So if you go to a car company and say this emergency braking system is there, he or she can show you. Now if you tell that customer, you know, we have a new robotic painting machine in the factory, he only asks one question, which is, so what? You can have anything you want. So the what the customer sees and what the customer cannot see needs to be understood when you understand innovation from a company perspective. Having said that, how can someone make money out of innovation is a question. Like I said, the first and foremost way of making money is making a new product. New product can be anything physical that we all see, cars, phones, computers, laptops, and so on. New service, what is a service, for example? Example of a service? Sorry?
Gmail
is a service. Airtel is what, product or service?
Service.
And example of product? Any physical product, car, phone, whatever, right? There's a third category I want you guys to pay special attention to, is patents and IP. This is a new category which, not new in the sense of patents, but a new category for monetization to companies, when more and more companies are focusing on how can they bring up something new, which they can give it to another company or another business to make money out of it. I'll explain in a bit. Just one point here. How many of you know BlackBerry? You're almost getting forgetting, right? Maybe another couple of years, I remember something called BlackBerry. How many patents could be in a BlackBerry 93 series phone? 1,000? 2,000? 1 lakh? Close to 10,000 patents. Okay. And an iPhone 3 is close to 20,000 patents. So where does it come from? It does not all come from research in motion, nor from Apple. They are patents that people like you and me have created. Okay. So there is a huge opportunity for us to do that. We will look at that also. Your role then, hence, from an innovation perspective, is one side coming up with something new that is useful and different, and one side there is business. So your role is to connect these two. That means you should come up with something that you can make a business out of. Suppose there is a fruit vendor outside your college. he sells a, okay, now it's mango season, let's say mangoes. It's quite cheap, let's say 20 bucks, nice mango, and you want to eat it. Will you eat it every day? It's just 20 bucks, most of us can afford. When do you eat it? When do you want it? Now, if you make a product which no customer wants it, he will not buy. So that remains true for any business, whether it is A company, Wipro, Info, TCL, whoever does, it is the same thing. Are you making something for which he or she willing to pay? Option number two, okay, you don't want to eat. Why don't I give him 20 rupees and go? You know what, I like mango, but today I don't want to eat, but keep 20 rupees. Why you are laughing? What's wrong? So you go and tell your customer, okay, you don't like my product, that's okay, but pay me. That's exactly how it sounds. So it's a very simple way of understanding. If you don't make something that they want, they will not pay for it. How do you all buy a phone? The research is how long? 6 months, right? What is the first step? You start on the internet, then you do a friend research, then you do a market research, then you go back to internet, then you do a price research. After this, you go to the shop and ask, do you have that model? Yeah, I have that model. You are asking as if you have never seen that model. You know everything, but you still want to know what is in it that you have not understood at all. So you've been very sure of what you want. So when you're talking about millions of dollars in a business or a car, you can imagine how careful people will be. And if you're not carefully understanding that, you cannot create that. That is a primary message there, okay? So we talked about patents. I specifically wanted to emphasize that I said. Let us look at patents as the number of patents in the phone I asked you to guess. This is a simple rat, okay? There is a service to kill rats. Okay, how many patents could be there on how to kill a rat? Not technical, no electronics, no computation, nothing. How many patents could be there in this non-technical field of killing rats? 1,000? I have counted 103. Probably there are more. There are 100, 200 patents for trousers, how to grow a mustache, you can name it. It's there all over the place. So idea is, if you can find a way to do something in a better way than most people, people want to have it. Okay? Like I said, this has 20,000 patents. It starts from how is the curve, how is the glass fixed, how is the body fixed to the... Everything up to how your memory loads, how do you clean your memory, how the flash... boot ROM loads, everything. How quickly does the Apple logo appear? Everything is a patent. So if you have that little idea, it still counts in the big picture. This has 20,000 patents, by the way. And that means most of them are not from Apple. So that means people like you and me have. I keep saying this, not to tell how many patents I have. If I have 20, you can have 50. It's no big deal, but you have to do something correctly to get there, okay? Now, I'll show you a real example which does not involve that much of technology at all, so that you get the basic message of need versus creating something that is needed. Have you seen this before? Yeah? Where? In Bangalore? Somewhere else? This is a patent somebody has. They put up for sale. Okay? Why I am showing you this, there are hundreds of things that you can do. Every week, every month you can do this kind of stuff. This is a way to carry pizza. Usually when you go and take pizza, which I am sure all of you are aware, you will buy X pizzas, maybe one or two, depending on how many roommates you have and which day of the month it is. And then you get a bottle of drink, then you get a couple of napkins and maybe some sauce and stuff like that. To make the whole thing experience easy to carry, somebody has come up with this. You might think, is it a good idea? I think so. It's easy to carry, it's useful, it's new, so it qualifies to be an innovation. This guy who has come up with this has put it up for sale. Okay, and it really, it's really, you can Google it. He has put it up for sale. For how much? Guess, in dollars. I can tell you one thing, my talk is very easy. Mathematics is coming, so you better wake up. Okay? How much would this patent be, somebody expect for such a patent? You don't have to buy, you have to just guess. Sorry? Ten what?
$10.
Sorry?
$10.
So, I will tell you the fact the business is, if somebody, this is my idea for sake of discussion. If I sell this idea, Domino's can put their logo here, Pizza Hut can put their logo here, and they can use millions of boxes because they sell millions of pizzas. The money he is asking is $150,000. There is something with the font, so I don't know what. So $150,000 is what he is asking. Can you imagine? Probably you don't have to work for 3 years. Just make something nice, give it to someone, and then you are done. Why I am giving this example is, simple things like this creates value because if somebody wants it. And if you can find that, you can make a lot of value. Now think of all the things you can do technically. Okay, lots and lots of things you can do. In that case, how big is this problem? How big is this opportunity that people want innovation, companies want innovation, and we are not able to do it? You need to understand one thing. Companies are made up of people. There is nothing called an idea generation office in a company, which is like a computer, and somebody says, I want three ideas will come out in a printout. It doesn't happen. Where does it come out of? People. Who are those people? Probably some of you are going to join those companies. So it is you. It depends on you. The problem is there. Only 4% of people in a good multinational technical center in India, only 4% of the people. So that means if you have 1,000 people, you have 40 people thinking like this. And not all that you think becomes successful either. So if this is 4% and there is only hit rate of 1% or 5%, you are talking about sub-zero kind of a number to succeed. That is why you see in 2016, India filed 42,000 odd patents, of which 36,000 patents were already filed in another country. So that leaves us with 6,000 new patents divided by 1.3 billion. No, don't divide because there is too many zeros after the decimal. It's not worth it. Now, is that the potential we have? No. Our potential is not that, but the problem is that big. That means the opportunity is that big for you to create something. Okay? If you don't do that, what happens to these companies? 2 out of 3 organizations will disappear without innovation. That's why I started with BlackBerry. Which is the other company which you know that disappeared for almost?
Kodak.
Nokia, GE is getting shaken. GE, can anybody imagine GE, anything could happen to GE? Their turbines are 14-story building heights. You know, so that kind of companies can also get affected. It is not the company is doing anything wrong. It is that the company is doing something wrong in the sense of not doing something. Imagine an escalator that is coming down and you are walking up. So that is the competition you face. At a certain speed, you are still at the same place. And that is not good enough. So what they did was not bad, but it was not good enough. And that's what happens to companies. So now you understand, if companies need this, you are the people who can going to make a difference to these companies, come up with innovation. If you look at startups, topmost reason, 95% of the startups failed in Bangalore was a study done by IBM last year. Number one reason of the 10 is this, building something that nobody wants. And there is a reason, there is a psychology behind it. We have been engaged with startups also. We were supposed to have a half an hour mentoring, 1 hour mentoring with a startup which was already 2.5 years into their startup business. 3.5 hours later, 1 hour discussion has become 3.5 hours, they could not tell us what problem they were trying to solve. Example is like this, we are having a product which is a digital mirror, which tells you, which shows you, if you press a button, which is called a dress, it will show you that dress on you. Like lens card show you the glasses online. Okay? Said, fine, that is not my asking. What is the problem? So if I go to Vivek and say, Vivek, I have innovated a very new medicine. This tablet, if you take, you will have relief from headache. Why, Vivek, you will not take? Will you take? Why you will not take?
I don't have
it. No, but I have worked hard. I have spent 3 years. It has no effect, no side effect, whatever you want to call it. Why you will not take? Because you don't have a headache. All I did wrong was, I forgot to just check with you, do you have a headache? All that was needed was that. And I spent 3 years now. Most of our success factors comes by asking this first question before going ahead, which is not what we do. Which is exactly not what we do. What is the problem is, how many of you drink this? Okay. This is a solution. What is the problem? For, like you have cough, you take Benadryl. You are thirsty, you drink water. So what is that you have that you drink Mountain Dew? You have something, some problem or whatever. Some need, let's say. What is that? What is written here? Means what?
Yes.
Whenever you have that, you have to drink this. Right? I am not saying that's it. Means, you go to Mount Everest, you feel scared to climb. Have this. Because Benadryl cures cough, so this should cure. Is it true? Not possible. What about this? Watch this side. This is an app to control this. This is a solution to which problem? If I said some, you said you won't buy mango if you don't want it. Why do you not want it? Which problem? This is not a proof of concept. This is a product. 2,49,000. You know average price of a commodity? 8,000, good one. How many you can buy? You can do Swachh Bharat around your area. full area. This is called where you can do things without a need. I have done also. My previous job, I was supposed to come up with an IoT device. You know IoT?
Yes,
everybody says I know it. Okay. They said, come up with an IoT device for your home. I said, no, it is not possible because there is no need for an IoT device at home. They said, no, we have to. We are a technology company, we should demonstrate leadership. I said, okay, let me think of something and do. So I picked up an induction stove and I made this kind of an app. So my mother is my test case, so I went to her, put it on the table. I still remember that day, put it on the dining table and I said, do you know this? I said, of course, induction stove. I said, that is not the beauty. Look, I'll show you the beauty. I took my phone, said, I can control with this. She looked up, she was to my right side. She looked and said, why would you do that? I said, why not? You're sitting next to it. And you're controlling by app? She said, yeah, that's true. Okay, I'm smart, I'm an engineer, blah, blah, blah. I was going to China the next day. So I told her, look, I'm going to China tomorrow. She said, yeah, I can control from there. Then she said, and do what? Are you going to cook from there? Are you going to eat from there? Are you going to cook for me from there? What is the plan? Then I realized I'm doing crap. Because I can put a remote and connection and make this IoT, nobody will come and say, hey, IoT, let's buy. You will not buy for 20 rupees. Why will you buy thousands of rupees? All I did was I did not check what was needed. I'll give you the reverse also. You all have this experience of your mother or sister, somebody at home asks you to switch off the stove when the pressure cooker is kept after 3 whistles. I'm going out, 3 whistles, switch off. Right? How many of you actually do? I tell you why you are getting away. Neither they can prove it was 3, nor you can disprove it was not 3. That is the only reason. But look at it as an energy problem. Every household, 300 million household, 1 whistle per day, how much energy we are wasting? So I said, let's do something IoT there. If I now, this is a product also in the market 3 years ago, they patented one. We made an induction stove where you can set the number of visits. So the lady of the house or whoever is cooking, 1 to 15. when the pressure cooker has whistled that many times, the induction stove will switch off by itself. Is this not a good solution? I tell you why. People were being willing to pay 500 rupees more than a regular induction for this feature alone, because they can find value in it. And that is the difference. I can give you both sides of my own example. That is the difference it makes to know what it means to find out what they want, right? The cause for that problem is this. What do you make out of this picture? What is this could be? If it is my idea, it has to be good. Try selling your idea like I did. Impossible. If your idea is not what they want, however hard you try. So what happens is, when you start with an idea, you find a problem that does not exist. And you start telling people that is the problem for which they should buy your idea. They will not, because you will not buy a mango for 20 rupees if you don't want. Then after say, these people don't appreciate my idea. They don't understand the value of my idea. Idea is not there. The value of my becomes the story. Now the my starts to grow, and before you know, that takes precedence. And your whole startup fails because it is based on what you think is needed, not what actually is needed. The whole question then is, idea itself is not an innovation. It is just a start of something, right? So which comes first between these two? What is this? Which are, what is each of them, by the way? What is this?
Idea.
Idea, okay, and he's smiling. What is this? Why is he smiling for a problem? You should be happy if you find a good problem. There are a lot of problems. There is not every problem is a good problem. Good problem is which you, when you solve, somebody is willing to pay. I showed you not so good problems, which people have solved, including what I did. Right? The whole question is, your career anchors on this behavior. If you can take this and internalize this, you have settled your career for a long time, which I will explain. There are two basic parts. One is intrapreneur, one is entrepreneur. If you type this spelling in Microsoft, it shows in red, which means spelling mistake. You can try. This is a spelling mistake according to Microsoft. But that is not the point. This is, some people have an affinity to join a company. So that means, can you come up with something innovative within a company, then you are an intrapreneur. Entrepreneur is having your own setup, your own startup, your own business, whatever that is. The difference is, here you are responsible for everything for your business. Here you are responsible for everything except the resources that are needed to do it. Because the management of the company will say, yes, we will support you. No, this idea is not for us. That is the rest of the part, the big part which we discussed is exactly the same. Come up with the need, develop a solution, prove it, make sure it is a business fit. Right? Why is it such a big important thing is, World Bank made a report on innovation on India. Okay? They said India has a great potential innovation. Good, feels good till you read this. That it is not fully. This hurts. I get hurt by this statement. If I am a person who is not capable of doing something, there is not much I can do. But if I am a person who is capable of doing something and still don't do it, for whatever reason, it is a waste, criminal waste. Right? So what is it that you can do? Is essentially two things, skills and habits. Difference between them is habits is something that you keep repeating. How many of you are aware of which shoe you wear first every day? You are aware? So from tomorrow it change. Okay? Most of us not even aware which shoe? I don't know. Maybe tomorrow I will check when I start. This one is what you can learn and practice. Handwriting. We were not born with that. We developed that skill. And we can get better writing copy books. We have written so many, still nothing has helped. But we can keep trying. We can keep getting better and better. Right? My father used to write his handwriting is so bad that even he could not read. So I say, you are worse than a doctor. I don't know how they met. The guy will be taking it from doctor and he will give medicine also. And we cannot confirm because handwriting is so bad. But we can practice, right? So these are the skills that World Economic Forum said. In 2015, they said the industry needs people with these skills. They have 20 skills if you want to Google, do that homework. 1 to 20. I've taken 1, 2, 3. This was the skills they said need of the hour. Look what happened in now. They published in 17 the new set of 1 to 20. Look at 1, 2 and 3. This is innovation. 1 plus 2 plus 3 equals innovation. So, to be employable in any form, either as an intrapreneur or as an entrepreneur, you need to have this. You need to have these three skills. And that is what leads to your career as an intrapreneur or entrepreneur. Okay? Your role is to develop these skills. Okay? Well, how to develop that skill is, if you are a company, you have a customer. What do you deliver to the customer? What do you get from the vendor, mango vendor? What do you pay him? Suppose you are the mango vendor. What do you get? You get money. What do you give him? Value. So you create value, you get money. That's business. Businesses exist to make money. Of course, legally, ethically, all that is fine. But it exists, unlike an NGO, to make money. It's not for profit. So what's in it for me is there for everyone. Why would somebody want this? Why would somebody want that? Why does the company want to do this? Everybody does something to get something in return. Is it true or false?
Sure.
Then you can say, what about somebody in Himalayas, Sadhu? What does he want?
Moksha.
That's why he does what he wants. Everybody wants something. The question is, have you understood what they want? That is the only difference. It is like, you know, saying, if you go to zoo, people say, what is there to see in monkeys? They all look alike. Maybe monkeys are also thinking, what is there to see? They are all look alike. So it is not that there is no difference. It's our inability to differentiate that is the difference. This is the same. Companies who understand this well succeed very fast and very strongly. Companies who understand this weakly have a shaky ground. Their products are not solid. I have seen an advertisement in Bangalore, which is world's first detachable LED socket. So, what am I supposed to do? Remove it every day? Just because you can make it, it doesn't mean that it's valuable for me. LED bulb itself is not supposed to be removed 7 years. Why will I remove the socket? A lot of examples. AC. World's first AC with 0.1, 0.2 control. So, what am I supposed to do? 0.1, 0.2. Hey, you don't have a hat. So, what will you do? Did you think carefully what can? Nothing. Our phone is 0.17 seconds faster. So, what does it mean? Nothing. Go and tell your mom. Mom, this is iPhone 6, okay? Because your mom, she will listen, okay? Nothing else. This is 4GB ROM, okay? Quad core processor, okay? This is lithium polymer battery, not lithium ion, okay? 3900 milliampere, okay? Gorilla glass. That she had, Gorilla what? Till then she was like, okay, finished. Done? No, Gorilla. Oh. It does not matter. You tell her, if you drop this phone by from your hand, glass will not break. She understands that. Don't tell Gorilla chimpanzee. Tell what it means to her, she will understand. Your job as engineer is not to excite others with technology. You get excited, tell them the benefit. Okay, it's very simple but very, very much lacking in how we practice it. Lot of engineers come and do that, you know. We have this technology. How does it matter? That is the key question. How does it give the benefit? Because most of them, it is not that they cannot find the solution. It is not that they cannot find the problem. How many are ENC students? Okay, fantastic. I am also ENC. How does the lab work? The most knowledgeable person in the lab is the attender. New teachers also learn from attender. Students of course learn from attender. How? They will give you circuit. He will give you the components. He knows which components are needed. You are supposed to rig it up. It doesn't work. Whom do you call? Not teacher. He will come and fix. It is the person who knows the problem. Suppose, do it the other way. We'll give you a set of components. You rig up a circuit. no circuit will be there. Because that is like finding a problem. This is, we have mastered this art. Let me tell you, we have mastered this art of finding a solution. All the execution models that have tried in India are on this solution. Tell me what to do, I will do. I will do it fast, I will do it cheap, I will do it well also nowadays. But if you ask them, what should I do? I said, I don't know. People of companies, MDs, talked to me and said, I have people with 20 years experience, PhDs, MTechs, nothing wrong with PhD, who asked me, what am I supposed to do? I said, to hell with you, you are supposed to tell me what you are supposed to do. That's why I hired you. He said, no, I don't know. Then where should I go? I am the MD, nobody is there above me, and you are not telling me. So what should I do? Then BlackBerry's happened, Nokia's happened, Kodak's happened, GE's happened, not because of anything, because of the people. It is about knowing this. You master this art, you will be in demand throughout your life. Right? It is very simple. Management students are paid more than technical students. You know why? As you go up in the hierarchy, CEO gets more than CTO. Why? Because he tells them which problem to solve. They all run around and solve it. This is easy, this is not. Okay? It depends on two things. One is critical thinking and one is creativity. Critical thinking is like peeling an onion. What is the actual problem? Imagine I have an onion and I peel the first layer. So what did I remove? What is this piece? Is it onion or not? No? Yes? There was an onion just a minute ago. I removed one layer. Onion? What is remaining? That is also onion. So which is the onion? Both are onion. Problems are like that. You don't know what is actually the problem. You do a lot of critical thinking, experimentation, understand what is the problem. Let's say GDP of India is a problem. Let's say. How to solve it? Oh, there is a knob in Arun Jaitley's room. You just have to increase 7.3 to 7.4 using anything. Possible? What does he have to do? There is an effect of so many things, and so many things are your control levers. If you move this, that needle will move. To find the right lever is the critical thing. Here you get correlation, causation. It's like saying, whenever there is more sales of ice cream, people spend more time in my swimming pool. Okay? So how to increase my people time spending in swimming pool? Sell more ice cream. Is it? That's the correlation. Data shows that. Correlation is not that. There's a confounding variable which says temperature does both. So getting to the bottom of the issue is the first step. Not this. This is the glamour part. This is the easy part actually. Okay? What is this? Lesson for you from today. Never answer immediately from today. Okay? What is this? I didn't say don't answer. I said don't answer immediately. If this is a solution, what is the problem? For whom is it a problem? Who are the two variables here? Mosquito and? Okay, let's take peel the onion. How is it a problem for mosquito? How will this solution help mosquito? How? Imagine, suppose you actually just feel and mosquitoes are in the room. Mosquito is happy. It goes anywhere. It bites anyone, but it doesn't know. Its stomach is full of blood, it doesn't know. What? How is the solution helping the guy, person? Mosquito comes. He is also happy. It bites, but he doesn't know it has bitten. He is also happy, right? Edward Ibono says, it is not creative thinking, it is not a talent. It is a skill, it is an exercise. By repeating, that's why skills and behavior you repeat in a way you want it and you develop a skill about it. For that, you need to do one thing, which is trying to be different. This is not easy. Why is this not easy? There is a research which says, children are very creative. Let's define children. In that research, they define children as 6 years. What happens at 6 years? That means, till 6 years, the creativity is quite high, and then it goes down.
They join school.
Do you remember your first day at school?
Yes.
What were you doing? That is just after you went to school. The day before, you had no idea what school is. New bag, new shoes, new dress. You said, good, I'm going to school. What is school? I don't know. Actually, you didn't know. First shock that day morning was your parents shock, and they left you. Said, why are they leaving now? What is this school all about? They used to be with me all these 5.5 years. Now they're leaving me and going, okay. You went in. First thing is you're walking around. Teacher, hey you, why are you dancing? All these years I was doing this only. No, I should not do. Okay, no. Okay, sit and talk. Hey, what? Why are you talking? All these I was doing this only. Now I cannot talk? No. Then you're looking here. Why are you looking here and there? Look here. I cannot look there also. I cannot talk. I cannot do anything. Why have we been doing all these years? Now I cannot do. So before you know, end of the day you are like this. And for 22 years it continues. Suddenly to become like this is not possible. But it is definitely in your reach to become like this. Only reason is you can decide to become like this. Or not. Both ways. If you want to be safe, I get people to counsel. Say, sir, I have finished my plus two. I want to join engineering. I said, fantastic. Where? College X. This is a real case, but I will not mention the college name. In Bangalore. College X. Oh, good. Why? By the way. Why is my question? Because why, what to do is important. I said, mechanical faculty is good. I said, something is missed here. Okay, in college, why? I know telecommunication faculty is good. He understood the point. No, but my friends are joining. So that's even worse. Because you are doing something because you don't have a reason why you are doing what you are doing. How many of you have Facebook account? How many of you do not have Facebook account? Fair has. No? 1, 2, 3. Okay, those who raised the hand, do you not have now or you had and you have given up after the data breach? All of you never had? Why did you not have?
They don't feel the need of it.
So many people feel the need of it, you don't feel the need of it. They have, why do you have? You ask, he's telling no need. You have it, no? Why?
So that we can get
the
updates.
See, you can get updates.
What will I do with that
update? What will you do with the update?
Regarding latest news or politics, elections, technology.
Tell. Either join or convince her.
Those things are not needed at this point of time.
It's needed for you? I don't want you to become enemies. The whole idea was, it does not matter as long as you know why you are doing what you are doing. Most of us skip that step. Because everybody does, I also do. Right? And that is not a reason at all. That is no way it's going to make your career anything better than anybody else's career. Right? To do that, you need to be different. Let's do a simple thing. I have to go from Mangalore to Udupi. Let's know Mangalore to Coorg. Okay? How do I go there? Which route should I take? I have route 1 or route orange, route blue, route black, route green. I said, don't answer immediately. Which route should I take? You can answer now.
Depends.
Green? Okay. Orange?
Depends.
Huh? Somebody said something else.
Depends.
Don't answer. Depends. How do you know what I want? Orange is for what? Green. You said green? Why green? Which green is 5 years? This is straight? Okay. Okay. Orange, somebody said, why orange? Yeah. Did I say that I need to go there quickly? That's why I said don't answer if you don't know what they want. It's like asking L&T, can you build me a bridge? They just tell you a project report. But they never asked, why do you need a bridge? Maybe it was not necessary, maybe something else was enough. You add value to your customers by knowing what they want, that is by asking. It's like asking, what is 8 plus 8? Now you can answer quickly. No, you are totally good. When should I answer quickly? When should I not answer? What is 8 plus 8?
16.
Now if I say, what all adds up to 16? You get options. Our job as innovators is to generate options. Let them choose based on what they want. If I want help, time, I choose one. If I want to help, cost, I choose one. If I want to go with my friends, I want the route to be the longest. I don't want to reach school. I want to reach as late as possible. 3 straight lanes I will take. Time, distance, cost, maybe something else. I don't know. Maybe something else. If you don't know this, don't give a solution. Your solution should work depending on what you know that they want, right? So, now I want you to write the formula for F0. Sir, can I ask? It's fair? Yeah. F0 equals? What is F0? Okay, let's do it the other way. What is that impedance of this circuit? Z equals? R plus? R plus 2 pi fl or omega plus 1 over
1 by C.
Right? When is the impedance of this the minimum? At F0. This F0, the gain is the maximum. If you are 3 dB below, slightly off F0, you are say 3 dB below, how much is the gain less? So if you are able to be productive at 100%, you'll get 70.7%, right? About 70%. If you don't find what you like, that is what will happen to your productivity. The more you move away, the more loss will be in your gain. Then what happened? I don't like this work. I have seen in Bangalore, 7 o'clock in the morning, the bus is going to office. They're all... As if the whole mind that it sleep. How can you go and start a day fresh with that kind of energy level? It's impossible. Because if mornings are productive for 9 out of 10 people, and if I'm sleeping at 7 o'clock in the morning after taking bath, imagine my interest. It is not possible to have interest. When you don't have interest, everything becomes difficult. If we reach home after trip at 11 o'clock at home, then we say, can we have dinner? My sister will jump and say, no, at this time I cannot cook. She doesn't like. My mom says, 10 minutes, food will be ready. She likes. The difference between hard work and not hard work is that I like it, I don't like it. If you like it, it's not hard work. Effort is required. If I have to lift a stone, just because I like it, it will not come up. Right? I still have to lift it. But I like to lift it, so whatever it pains, I'm okay to pay. But if I don't like it, even a stone is difficult to lift. You need to figure out what is your F0. Is it possible to play this video? I think you have to use the video itself. My help. I was helping you. Who said this was my help needed? You assume. So you cannot assume anything, and you have to understand the context. To understand the context, you need to know where you are, and to do that, you need a little bit of thinking. That's why I said, do not offer a solution if you don't know the problem. It's okay if you take 1 day extra, 1 week extra, 1 year extra. It's still fine. But if you don't know the problem, you should not be answering the question at all. Right? But you need to take your chances. Do take your chances. Before you take the chance, understand the concept. And with that, you can handle most of the jobs that you can get in your career. So that's all I wanted to say. Hope it was useful. Thank you very much.